I have something I have to tell you guys, and it's not a super easy thing for me to say. Actually, can't believe I'm saying this to you guys right now, but all right, Callie, just say it. I am not a millionaire. I know, equally surprised. It's hard to believe. It's okay if you're shocked. Just because I'm not a millionaire doesn't mean that I can't have some millionaire-like habits. Now, as some of you guys might know, my husband and I have, since the beginning of the year, been doing a lot of things to be financially smarter, budgeting and saving money. And in doing that, we've also been sort of just educating ourselves and looking at what people who are really smart with their money do. So what I'm going to do today is break down some of the habits that most self-made millionaires have so that you can start adopting them yourselves and get on the path to making your first million. The first habit that self-made millionaires have is they are early risers. I read a study by author Thomas Corley, and he found that more than 50% of self-made millionaires tend to wake up at least 3 hours before their workday actually begins. Waking up early in the morning not only allows you to be more prepared for the day, but it also allows you to do things on your to-do list that maybe you wouldn't have had time for before. Thomas writes in his book that getting up at 5 a.m. to tackle the top 3 things you want to accomplish in the day not only is going to help you regain control of your life, but it's going to give you a sense of confidence and control. The next thing that most self-made millionaires do is stay aware of their financial health. And what this really means is staying on top of your credit score. It's important for people of all ages to really start thinking and staying on top of what their credit score is. And personally, I like to use Credit Sesame to do this because you can get a 100% free credit tool. Now, not only does knowing your credit score obviously mean that you are going to know what you're eligible for when it comes to things like interest rates and loans, but staying on top of your credit is also going to make sure that you know where you can improve and you know where you stand right now. As you continue to monitor your credit over time, you'll be able to see what financial actions actually impact your credit score. So, like I said, I use Credit Sesame. I will have a link to creditsesame.com in the description down below. You can get a 100% free credit score there, and you can continually check it so you can stay on top of your credit and really know what your financial health is. Oh, one other little perk when you sign up for a free membership with Credit Sesame is you'll get free identity theft up to $50,000. Okay, a third habit of self-made millionaires is they have a budget. And they don't just have a budget, but they have a budget and they stick to it. This has to do with having an understanding of all the money you have coming in every single month, and then what money you have going out for your living expenses. Then setting a strong budget for what you're going to spend on other things like going out and entertainment, and really sticking to it. A really good way to get started with that is to use the 70-30 plan. If you don't know what that is, 70-30 plan means that you actually only live off of 70% of your income after taxes. It means that you're giving yourself a real idea of what your standard of living is and make sure that you're not living above your means. Living above your means usually means you're overspending and likely accumulating credit card debt. If you're currently living on more than 70% of your taxed income, I know it can be a little bit hard to sort of cut back to that 70%. And I actually have a video where I share 10 things that I cut from my budget, and I will link that down below. It's a really great place to get started that'll have you sort of looking at the things that you currently spend money on and seeing where you can cut back. Going off the budgeting habit, another habit that all self-made millionaires do is they pay attention to even the small costs. This is a financial mistake that I used to make myself, where you sort of look at little costs and you kind of, well, you don't look at them. Actually, you overlook them. You say it was just $3 for that coffee, or I only paid $2 more to get that name brand, whatever. Or it's only $10 a month for this app that I never use. I'll cancel it eventually. Self-made millionaires care about all costs, even those little ones, because they know that over time, even the little costs are going to add up and impact your budget. The next thing self-made millionaires do is they set goals. They don't just set daily goals, but they are setting weekly goals, monthly goals, yearly goals, and goals for their entire lifetime. So when it comes to financial goals, this could mean things like I'm going to save $50 this week, or I'm gonna pay off my credit card in the next 6 months, or I'm gonna save up to buy my first house in the next 2 years. And this is actually another place that creditsesame.com can help you out, because along with your free credit score, you can get a credit analysis and personalized financial tips and tools that update every month. Totally for free. This is going to allow you to set real and attainable financial goals and empower you to take control of your financial future. The next next thing that most self-made millionaires do is drive modest cars. I think we all know that buying a brand new car is never really the smartest. The minute you drive it off the lot, it is depreciating in value. In general, the average self-made millionaire doesn't waste their money on fancy, flashy cars. Cars can actually be one of the biggest money sucks in your budget when it comes down to car payments and car insurance and gas and repairs. So self-made millionaires know it's not worth it to spend their money on that. And they tend to buy used, reliable cars like Subarus and Hondas. Another common thread of self-made millionaires that I think is really interesting is they don't rely on a single source of income. Instead, they typically have multiple revenue sources. In that same study that I was telling you about earlier that Thomas Corley did, they actually found that over 65% of self-made millionaires were relying on three or more sources of income. Multiple sources of income can be all sorts of things. Obviously, it can be your normal 9-to-5 job, and then it can also be things like maybe real estate rentals, investments, owning or part owning a sort of side business. And actually, on one of my multiple sources of income, my business, CaffeinateAndConquer.com, I made a video kind of all about this, talking about how influencers and bloggers can generate multiple sources of income and why they should. So if you're interested in that, I will link that post and video in the description down below. The last habit of self-made millionaires that I really love is that they tend to be optimistic. It kind of is hard to get to millionaire status if you're really negative all the time or you're not willing to look at four positive solutions to problems. Long-term success, whether it's financial or otherwise, tends to really only be possible if you have a positive mental outlook on life. All right, guys, that does it for my habits of self-made millionaires. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned a little bit and maybe this empowered you to start adopting some of these habits. In the comments down below, I would love if you let me know one thing that you were doing right now to improve your financial future. Like I said, I will have a link in the description box down below for you to check out creditsesame.com. It is a great resource when you're sort of, you know, getting your financial health together, and if you really want to get empowered to improve your financial future, not only can you get a credit report completely free, but they have all of those other amazing tools like the credit analysis and the financial personalized tips that are updated every single month totally for free. Definitely take advantage of it and check it out. As always, thank you so much for taking the time to stop by and watch this video. I post new videos every single Sunday. I hope you guys are having a fantastic day, and I will see you all in my next video.